My thanksgiving is a weapon. My thanksgiving is a weapon. Thanksgiving is a necessity. Thanksgiving is what? It's a necessity. Thanksgiving is a necessity. Oh, David told us, he said, I will enter his gate. Psalm 100 verse 4. I will enter his gate with what? With thanksgiving in my heart. You want an unlimited access to the throne of God. Learn to thank the Lord. I will enter his gate with thanksgiving in my heart and his court with praises. Thanksgiving is the key that unlocks every door.
And a stone, but there was no sword in his hand. So the
a sword that can cut the head of your enemy off. Without you holding a sword, there is a mindset that can defeat the enemy. Even while you are in your bedroom without facing them. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. So you can conquer without fighting. You can conquer the Goliath without fighting. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Why? Because the battle is the Lord's. Hallelujah. Come on, say the battle is the Lord's. Come on, say the battle is the Lord's. The reason why most Christians suffer bruises and wounds and some even die in the battlefield is because we love to fight too much. We love to fight too much. We fight our husband, we fight our children, we fight our in-law, we fight our boss, we fight everybody around us. But today, I want to teach you how to hold your peace and let God do the fighting for you. How to go, listen, Christians, we are gentle on the outside, but we are huge on the inside. There is a battle that you can win on your knees. You have to decide there with spiritual spirit of God. Hallelujah. In spiritual battle, your battle and your weapon, they don't match. What did I say? They don't match. Your battle may be magnitude, may be magnificent, may be aggressive, but the weapon that you will use may be insignificant. And God orchestrated so that at the end of the day, no man will glory in themselves. How did David defeat Goliath? Let's look at verse 32, sir. Verse 32, thanksgiving. Thanksgiving from verse 32. And David said to Saul, let no man act fair because of him. Thy servant slew both the lion and the bear, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as one of them, since he hath defiled the armies of the living God. What did he do? He looked back and thanked God for the bear. He thanked God for the lion. He thanked God for the little things that the Lord has helped him to conquer. And he said, if the Lord has helped me to conquer the lion and the bear, I thank God. Are you thankful for what has happened to you in the past? Oh, when I looked at my life, I see nothing but the faithfulness of God. Born premature. Over 6 weeks in the incubator. In 1967, when medical science was wacky, but the Lord made me survive. Hallelujah. I looked back and I kept on reminding God, if you saw me when I had no clue who you are, when I had no clue to even tell you, God, I thank you, when I had no clue to pray, to dance, to worship, to adore, to worship you, if you saw me through that moment, everything along my path, you're going to see me through it. What's your testimony? What are you thankful to God for? Come and say my thanksgiving. It's a weapon. Come and say my thanksgiving. Come and say my prayer. I want to teach us how to challenge God to fight your battle while you relax. No demon, listen, demon can withhold your prayer. In the case of Daniel, Daniel was withheld. He was praying to God. God released his answer. But the demon just, the prince of Persia just held it down. But who can withhold your praises? Come on, hallelujah. Come on, say, nothing can stand against my praises. Come on, say, nothing can stand against my praises. Praises is something that you can never do amiss. When faced by a battle that is greater than you, when faced by circumstances that is stronger than you, what do you do? Praise your way out of that situation. Praise your way out of that circumstances. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shout your way out of it. I remember, Josephine can bear me witness. I woke up one day, had marinated all the chicken that I was going to bake that morning. And I woke up in the morning and said, Josephine, hold the gas and then put the chicken in the thing. And she came and said, Mommy, the gas is not working. I said, not in my house. She said, Mommy, I told you it's not working. I said, not in my house. I said, go put it on. And go put the chicken inside. I said, Mommy, I cannot do that. You know, our children, they are very rational. I said, I cannot do that. I said, okay, no problem. I said, tell your daddy the gas is not working. He went and told her the gas is not working. After some time, I came back upstairs. I saw that my husband had come and said, thank God for our husband. Come and say that. Because he's an engineer. Me, I'm not an engineer. He put the gas. He put the thing out. And I saw he was looking at the back and looking at the back. And I waited. He said, this thing is not working. I said, okay. I said, everybody, darling, pack it back together. Put it back in together. He put it back together. I said, test it whether it's working or not. He tested, he said, it's not working again. I said, that's good. I said, everybody, move back. Move back. Move back. Josephine, right? Where's Josephine? Everybody, move back. Move back. They all move back. I stood in front of the gas and I started to shout. Come on, say, my shout is a weapon. I came back with aggression. I said, move back, move back. God told me to shout more. And I shouted and shouted more. And I went back. I said, I'm going to go and take my shower now. See you later. I want to go take my shower. How many minutes later, Josephine?
5 minutes.
5 minutes later, Josephine ran down into the bathroom. Mommy, it's working. Is it working? It's working. It's working. It's working. It's working. It's working. It's working. Open, it's working. your wife, over a situation. When was the last time you gathered your children together and said, we're not going to pray about this situation, we're going to dance about this situation? Oh, I remember Debbie. Hey, Debbie, I don't need to share your testimony. When God was flowing from her body on a 3-month pregnancy, this, what did you do? She prayed.
Praise. I thank God for my mother.
You cannot thank someone you don't have a relationship with. What's your relationship with God like? Who is God to you? Is it just God in heaven? Or is God over every aspect of your life? Relationship will make you to thank God no matter what. Relationship will make you to exalt God no matter what. Relationship will make you to adore God in the biggest and the darkest day that you can ever think of. Hallelujah. He worshiped God. He bowed down before God. Listen, Job won that battle in that moment. That was the moment he restored everything. God said, wow, I'm giving you back double. Somebody is getting double this year. Please open there, my brother. Open there. Yeah. Lift up your head, holy gate. And begin lifting here, everlasting door. And the door asks a question. Who is that King of Glory? Ah. So lift up your head, holy gate. Begin lifting here, everlasting door. And then the King of Glory coming. He said, who is that King of Glory? What was the answer?
Salvation of the Lord with you. All you that Jerusalem, fear not, not be dismayed.
can cause a coup against them. But that was not what they used. They set up a singer to begin to worship the holiness of the Lord. They set up a singer to begin to praise the Lord. Let me tell you one thing worship and thanksgiving does. Thanksgiving shrinks the magnitude of your enemy and makes your God bigger. Thanksgiving shifts your perception of your problem. You no longer see the problem. You see more of God and less of that problem. The more you praise God for that problem, you see more of God and less of that problem. Oh, can you tell me how come the enemies were coming with magic, with guns and everything? All they could do was just to praise God and they started going. Hallelujah. And of course, you know the story. The Lord sent ambushment against them. They began to kill one another. And when they finished, it remained only one tribe. They took the one tribe that was left. They started fighting for each other. Hallelujah. My thanksgiving is a weapon that defeats the enemy. In our contemporary world, what of Tyson and Holyfield? Did you hear that story? Tyson was a multi, has won so many trophies because of his fighting. And one day, Holyfield said, I'm going to fight you, Tyson. And when they got to the ring, Holyfield in one side, Tyson in another side. Hallelujah. But Holyfield took the battle to the next level. What did Holyfield do? Why Tyson was gyrating and flexing his muscle, Holyfield stood at one side of the ring and said, be magnified, O Lord, you are highly exalted, and there is nothing you can't do, O Lord. Like this, I said, you are in church, so please read this. I rescued me and I turned it and I saw when prayer fails, try praises. At that time, my husband and myself, we had not slept for 4 days. Do you know what it means for you not to sleep for 4 days with a woman who had just had a baby? I was just looking at this baby 24/7. I saw it when prayer fails, try praises. I called my sister the following day and said, go to Oshodi. You may not know the place. Go get me 2 tambourines. I said, I'm taking this to the next level. She went, she got it. I said, tonight by 12 a.m. we're praising God and now this comes. This baby, at that time life was already going out of her. And I took the tambourine. By 12 midnight, everybody was sleeping. All the mothers with their babies were sleeping. I woke up, I called my sister, I said, it's time to praise God. You know, I told her, I told one of the nurses, I said, please allow my sister to be here. We have an assignment. He said, she has to sneak in at that time and then out when the thing is done. I said, good, no problem. And we started, we only sang one song. Jehovah, you are the most. Only one song, not 2 songs. Around Faith Bed. We did it between 12 and 12:30. One amazing thing happened. When we started doing this, other mothers left their babies. They came beside me and they joined me to sing the praises of the Lord. The nurses left their station. I'm telling you my story. They came, I joined, and we danced around their bed. After that, I went to bed. When I woke up the following morning, a new baby was born. Come and say, praise the Lord! The doctor comes to our bedside, he said, what happened to this baby overnight? And the doctor started calling everybody, get me a team, get me this, something has changed, the skin has changed, this baby is going to leave. I said, also you have given up. When people give up on your situation,
the name of the Lord.
Amen. Bible.